Okay, everyone, welcome to Melanie and Tamara. Mortgage broker or something, and
she's a real grown up. She's a real grown up.
Yeah, but then she's like, why do people ask me? Like, how do I know? And I'm like, girl,
you know.
She knows.
She puts her receipts in digital form.
I don't know.
I don't know.
How?
I don't know. She tried to teach me, and I don't know.
I'm gonna call her. How do I put my receipts in digital form?
It's a company thing. She has a company, she has to do it. That's mm-hmm. what
we all have to do it. We all are self-employed.
I just
put it in a shoebox.
What else?
I already told you that she blows her nose every night before bed.
How do you know Pat?
How do I know her? We did my XX together. That's how we met. Yeah, I was her best friend. We touched her boo.
How do you feel?
Yeah, that's doing the song.
And that wasn't in the script. Like, we were just doing.
But that's not the word.
Yeah, we're improv. Yeah. We're improv, and then we're done that way.
What? She improved a boob touch.
I am. Oh, cause she was like, she's broken up with her boyfriend, and I'm like, well, boy, stop. And I was like, is there something you want to tell us about? And I'm like, no.
Le cose che vogliamo sapere, diteci tutto quello che sapete. me la dice prima di tutto quel cartellone infestato, perché prima sono passata nel mondo come se io l'avessi spinto, però vabbè, forse il suo spirito è... quella a cui chiedono tutto, cioè si chiede di tutto perché è l'adulta del gruppo. Lei organizza praticamente digitalmente tutte le ricevute. Tamara dice: ma come faccio? Io le metto in una scatola di scarpe le ricevute, tutte le fatture, insomma, le cose burocratiche. Loro si rivolgono a lei per queste domande sul come diventare adulti. Tamara, non so, stavano parlando di un... non lo so, si conoscevano perché si toccavano le tette. In un film si erano conosciute, ecco, in un film, in questa scena dove lei era tutta coccolata così, si ricorda che a un certo punto la mamma era un po' così. Sì, perché forse Kat, il personaggio di Kat aveva rotto con la fidanzata. Era una scena un po' così tutto emotiva e quindi stava così, è vero.
Good book.
Però delle belle tette.
Oh, I have one book, yeah. She says she isn't organized.
Oh, come on.
She says she doesn't know what not being organized is. So I was at her house and she has her jewelry organized. And I mean, they're in like little, like this plastic box, and she's like, yeah, this is my travel one, and then this is like, it's like, everything's like written in boxes and organized, and she's not organized. Also,
she once, we were talking about, because I can't sit still long enough to get my nails or toenails painted, I don't like it, and sort of like, get me out of here, and she's like, no, honey, honestly, and she's like, I don't feel like I have my life together unless I can look down and think of my nails are painted. But it's actually really serving, I think.
Yeah.
Really sweet. But they don't have to be painted, but they have to be groomed. Otherwise, she can't. Really cute.
Praticamente Kat dice di non essere organizzata, ma in realtà, cioè, è organizzatissima, perché gira anche con le scatole per i gioielli, dice sì, questa è solo quella da viaggio, cioè tutto organizzato e belle con le targhette, e niente. Nella dice io non riesco a stare ferma quando mi fanno le unghie, invece Kat dice no, la mia vita non ha un senso se le unghie non sono a posto, devono essere almeno limate. Con lo smalto sì, però almeno limate sì, perché altrimenti la sua vita non ha senso.
Hi, I was wondering, what do you usually tell your son about what you do on set at work?
Your mind's too young to know.
What are you going
to do? Never been told. No. It's hard because my stepson, who's six, is like, you're on TV! He doesn't really, it's still computing. I don't know. Yeah.
Good answer.
Okay. I don't know. Yeah. What would you say? What would you say?
He came to work.
Oh, yeah, he came to work.
And I'm like, hang on, I'm just going to kick down the door. Can you?
I think you're like superwoman. Kicking down doors.
He thinks it's pretty cool.
Right.
Yeah.
What does your mom do? Work in an office?
Well, that's what I tell people who, like, yes, on the street, I was walking down the street, and this man was like, so what do you do? I'm like, accounting. Like, and then he's like, oh. Nowhere else to go. It's great.
Yeah.
Just, oh, when you don't want to talk to people, I'm an accountant.
Oh, I see. Yoga.
What would I tell my son? It's more like my son's friends. That's weird. Because I don't know if they're going to make fun of him. I don't know if they're going to be cool. Or I don't know if they're going to be like, you think you're so great. So, but usually their parents tell them. Their parents say, yeah, she's a real asshole when she's on TV.
La domanda era cosa dite ai vostri figli, sul, cioè parlate del vostro lavoro, dite cosa fate sul set, e Tamara non sa rispondere, dice vabbè, a 6 anni è difficile, non saprei sinceramente cosa dire, però lui dice beh, io direi semplicemente sono andata a lavoro, comunque il suo figlio crede che sia molto vivo quello che fa. E la cosa più difficile forse è parlarne agli amici dei figli, però di solito sono i genitori stessi che dicono sì sì, è una grande
stronza.
Vabbè, lo dicono direttamente i genitori. Comunque di solito quando non vuoi parlare con le persone, magari per strada, quando ti chiedono ma che fai nella vita, dici sì, sono una contabile, alla fine nessuna domanda.
You could speak Italian all day, and I'd be like, oh my god. Speak Italian to me. No.
Hello.
Hi.
So I hear from my kids from kindergarten many stories from their homes. So I wonder, are you careful at your home too? Are you careful at your home? What do you say or what do you do so your sons don't go back to school and tell everything you teach them?
They do. They do, and then they get in trouble. And I'm like, the teacher's like, oh, you know, Gerald's been saying some potty words at school.
Like what?
Like, but. Or like poo.
Oh my god.
I know. And I'm like what? And she's like butt and poop. And I'm like, and like those are the words that we use at home. And then I have to tell my husband, like, I do not use potty words because he gets in trouble at school. And he's getting in trouble for using butt. Bottom. What do you say, bottom?
No, you say butt.
Yeah. Yeah, I got mine reversed.
Give me yours, I want to know.
Fucking. Yeah. He said, my mama says, what is it? But he said it in French, it was so cute. It's like, my mama dit le S word, and shit. Et le F word, beaucoup. That's French for my mommy. Anyway, I'm a big potty mouth. I try to behave. I honestly, I'm less worried about like bad words and more worried about bad behavior. Like if he's like a bad person,
yeah.
Like I'd rather he understand, you know, the value of people versus like saying yes. But. Stop with my butthole.
I
like they're good people, but they can say haughty words.
Yeah.
What do you say to the parent? Oh, what do you say?
You're a teacher.
Are we going to get in trouble?
What am I saying to?
What do you say to parents when the kids say, my mom says, fuck?
I don't tell them.
It's sort of
a lot of stories, but I don't tell them. It's only between the kids and me.
Nice.
Parlate a casa quando sono i vostri figli in giro, perché sento storie delle maestre che comunque dicono tuo figlio dice queste brutte parole, come culo, cacca. Melanie dice che lei cerca piuttosto di comportarsi bene, non tanto di stare attenta a ciò che dice, perché l'importante alla fine è insegnare i valori veri ai figli, non tanto le brutte parole, cioè quello sì, vabbè, però l'importante è il valore che insegni, quindi comportarsi bene.
first of all.
Hi.
I was wondering, which is your favorite TV show, TV series, in the past, maybe? Which one you would have loved to be part of, maybe? Currently, you would have thought, oh, it would have been perfect for that one, I should have done it.
Watched it like one after another. Have you seen The Boys? No? It's really cool. It's like everyone, like a lot of people have superpowers, and then there's regular people. So you live in a world of a lot of superheroes. I'd love to do The Boys. That would be funny. Yeah.
Okay, well, I just was obsessed with Fleabag.
Yes!
So I don't think I could do it better than her, but oh my god, that would be so fun.
I've never seen Fleabag.
Watch it. Awesome.
And then I'm gonna be like, I know, I'm gonna be like,
no, you won't.
No,
she's
no,
so,
she's
good.
So good. But I feel like you guys, because I've seen the previews and stuff. I feel like you guys have similar,
She's a horny potty mouth.
Similar.
How do you translate horny potty mouth? Yeah. I won't.
I won't.
La domanda era qual è il vostro show preferito e quale show vorreste in quale show vorreste vorreste recitarvi, quale show vorreste far parte? Tamara dice The Boys, che ha guardato praticamente un episodio dopo l'altro e mi è piaciuto tantissimo. È questa serie dove ci sono sia supereroi che gente normale e le piacerebbe tantissimo far parte di questo show. Mentre Melanie dice Fleabag, che I haven't watched it. Che vabbè, la protagonista per lei comunque è perfetta, però sì, avrebbe fatto piacere anche far parte di questo show. Ma pensa che Melanie potrebbe essere perfetta per fare la protagonista di noi, mi sa così.
Hi, what's your favorite Disney movie? Kind of funny movies.
What is what?
Favorite Disney movie.
Little Mermaid, but I do love Aladdin too. I've always loved Aladdin, but Little Mermaid, I don't know, something about Flounder. Flounder!
Ooh, I feel like you're gonna say something evil. I would never want to watch them now, but I loved, my middle name is Neige, which means snow in French. And I was very pale as a child, so I was like, am I Snow White? And so I would like, and I had a little like brown hair like bowl cut, which is very sickly. So maybe Snow White, just because. And then is Pinocchio not Disney?
Yes.
It is?
Yes.
Pinocchio.
Is he Italian?
Yeah. But I don't know it. I only thought in English, sorry.
Allora, film, cioè, forse il Disney preferito, Tamara Aladdin, ma è anche la Sirenetta perché, cioè, Flounder lo ama praticamente. Mentre Melanie non li guarderebbe adesso, ma da più piccola, dato che il suo secondo nome è Neige, che in francese vuol dire neve, pensava di essere Biancaneve, poi all'epoca era molto pallida, aveva i capelli a caschetto neri, quindi diceva, ma sono io Biancaneve? Insomma, gli piace anche Pinocchio.
Hi, this time I'm standing here in
someone
else. What's your favorite memory with
pets? Memory.
I would do really hung out was we went to the mall. I was pretending not to be pregnant. So she was like, I asked her, because I hadn't spent time with her in season one at all, because we never saw each other. We never really worked together. I was like, I'd like to know who this person is. So I invited her to go, and usually liked flea markets. So I was like, would you like to go to a flea market? And then she's like, yes, I'll pick you up. And then I was like, oh shit, I'm pregnant, I'm gonna puke. So let's go to the mall. But I didn't tell her I was pregnant. Anyway, so the whole time she was like, so if we go to season two, blah, blah, blah. And I was like, oh God, if we go to season two, I'm pregnant. And the whole time I was panicking anyway. It was really cute. And then, I don't know. You know, it's just any time we spend time together, it's just very, like, we have very real conversations. We talk about our insecurities, and it's, I just find that we're able to, like, lift each other up. So, all of the times, I guess. All of the times we've spent together doing something other than work, because it's been
Kat is very attentive. Like when she listens.
Oh yeah.
Yes. Yes.
Like, can you just pretend you're not listening? Yeah, I think one of the most recently was when we were going to a con together, and we were talking so much that we got lost in the front. I think that happened with you too. But we were a little bit better with it. We were walking in the airport, and so that happened with you, but it also happened with Kat. But Kat was worse because she has no sense of direction, which I didn't know. And I'm like, okay, I'll count on you, because I always count on you, because you're the reliable one.
She's the adult.
Yeah, she's the adult. And I was the one figured it out.
Allora, la domanda era qual è il ricordo preferito che avete di Kat? E Melanie ha parlato della volta in cui sono state al centro commerciale. In realtà lei sapeva che Kat ama i mercatini delle pulci, quindi voleva invitarla lì, però nel frattempo era comunque incinta, ma non l'aveva detto a lei, quindi ha detto che forse è meglio se andiamo al centro commerciale. E ogni volta che parlavano della stagione che stavano per girare, lei pensava sempre a Dio sono incinta, Dio sono incinta, e non gliel'aveva detto. Comunque i ricordi belli, diciamo che sono forse tutti quando si trovano insieme e fanno cose che esulano dal lavoro, anche perché parlano delle loro insicurezze, si stimolano a vicenda, si tirano su a vicenda. Tamara dice che Kat è una persona che si ascolta molto attentamente, cioè quando le parli, lei sta lì, ti guarda e dice cavolo, potresti anche far finta di ascoltare meno. Si ricorda anche una volta in cui erano andate a una con insieme e si sono perse in aeroporto. Di solito Kat deve stare tutta quella... Comunque Kat praticamente non ha senso dell'orientamento, quindi è stata Tamara a ritrovare la via quella volta.
Having it.
Speculation or theories about the season 4?
Well, I suspect there's gonna be a hunt for Waverly and Doc. Okay, I know. I don't have. Such a hard question. Like, will there be a sword? Will Peacemaker come back? Will Mama come back?
Ooh,
yes.
All of it needs to happen. All of that needs to happen.
Yeah.
In the bedroom.
No.
I don't
know.
For Rosita to come back?
Yes. For Rosita to come back?
Yeah.
How would Rosie come back? It's hard to say because there's no revenants. So is she a revenant still? Like, are we, like, how does that? I don't know.
But she didn't get killed.
She didn't get killed, but the spell is
broken.
So
but did
how
they get
is
to
that?
Live their lives or did they die?
What?
Did they get to live their lives now, so, or did they die? Did
yeah, do they die? Do they stay? Are they human now?
Are you leaving the triangle?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
I leave the triangle behind my head and stop studying. Actually, go see Milan. She read so much about it. No. Yeah, I think she's gonna come back somehow. Maybe. Like that. That's what's gonna happen.
Okay. E la domanda era se avevano delle teorie sulla quarta stagione, e Melanie pensa che John, ovviamente ci sarà una caccia a Waverly e Doc, ovviamente cercheranno di ritrovarli. E poi si chiede, ci sarà una spada, non ci sarà una spada, magari torneranno Xavier, la mamma, non si sa, non lo sa, magari Rosita tornerà, però ovviamente questo è un punto da finire, perché comunque adesso non ci sono più redi vivi e quindi Rosita sarà umana, vivrà il triangolo, cosa farà?
Guardate i piedi. Sono fatti!
Winona and Rosita ever dated. So, if that were to ever happen, what do you think their first date would be?
Where would their first date
be? Well, you can't take me to a hot tub.
Okay, I gotta step it up then. Yeah, right? Well, you wouldn't even do a hot tub anyway.
Oh.
Maybe to like a donut shop.
Maybe
a
donut shop. Candy shop. We could have so much fun in.
Whiskey. Yeah, you can go whiskey tasting.
Yeah, whiskey tasting.
Oh, that's the right answer.
That's the right. Yes, we're both alcohol.
Yes. Well, yes. But you mix your stir mix a lot,
and I mix for you.
They go shoot guns.
Yeah. No drinking and shooting.
Extra, then.
You can shoot before. Yeah.
Oh my
my god, yeah. We can go shooting. Yeah. And then I would impress Winona would impress Rosita with her shooting skills. Rosita would impress Winona with her mixing skills.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. Great combination.
Like, maybe we can go laser tag.
Okay.
In real life, play laser tag.
And then go have a casserole.
That's another one of my favorite cat moments. Like, if we have laser tag for a birthday.
Who wants with the crew? With the crew.
I started from the back and it's my name. She wants that. They want it. You are everyone.
Yeah.
It's your fault?
Yeah.
You put voodoo on her.
What?
Yeah. You did a voodoo. Yeah. So the first question is for you.
Come sarebbe il primo appuntamento tra Rosita e Winona? Tamara dice sicuramente non la sauna, forse magari in un negozio di ciambelle quello sarebbe più appropriato, o magari da assaggiare whisky in giro. In realtà forse quello che potrebbe essere l'appuntamento perfetto sarebbe appuntamento in cui tutte e due fanno vedere le loro abilità come tiratrici, quindi andare a sparare da qualche parte, mentre nella vita vera probabilmente andrebbero in una stanza con i laser, con le spade, con le pistole laser.
Yeah. I don't understand a word because I only speak Italian. But yeah, I love Sicily and Italian.
I only speak Italian.
As in, I could. What's it? What do they say? I don't know. They don't open their mouths when they talk. Because they're so fast. So yes, and I'm going back, I think, next year.
And this one? Is for Tamara, because they asked Tamara before, how was it to kiss dog with the
it was weird. It's weird, because you don't feel his lips, you just feel air.
Right?
I mean, you know more than I do, but
you eat his hair.
It's weird.
One more, and that's it. Do you prefer kissing dog or women?
Oh, how was it?
Oh, man. Yeah, there is only one. It's definitely Waverly.
Melanie ama la Sicilia, tutta la. Molti parenti che parlano solo italiano, ovviamente, e lei non li capisce perché nemmeno aprono la bocca quando parlano, parlano velocissimo.
Solo siciliano.
Solo siciliano.
Io parlo solo.
Okay. Sì, parlo solo italiano, ma loro parlano siciliano e quindi non si capiscono molto. E poi parlano velocissimo e comunque andrai in Sicilia il prossimo anno. La domanda per Tamara invece è. Com'è baciare Doc con i baffi? E le dici che è strano, ovviamente, perché non riesce a sentire le labbra, sono solo peli. È strano. È meglio baciare Doc o Waverly? E le dici che Waverly.
I'm not gonna risk it again to ask a question about cats, but if Winona and Rosita, what source of trouble would Winona and Rosita get any together?
I mean, it depends. Do they break?
Is Winona pregnant on a pool table? Because I feel like we were just talking about how rude that was.
Yeah, I punched. She's like, didn't you punch Waverly? I'm like, no, I punched you. Like, she punched you, right?
Yeah.
And she's pregnant. Giving birth on the pool table.
Yep. Okay, so what would we do? What kind of trouble would we get into?
I think Winona would definitely get into your chemicals.
and like mess with your neighbors,
like all of it, yeah. all of it, and not know what she was doing at all.
Yeah, yeah.
And that would.
I would definitely. I think Winona causes like a rift in the time space by mixing all the wrong things.
Yeah.
And then Rosita has to fix it.
In che guaio si caccerebbero i loro personaggi? Melanie dice che Winona probabilmente si metterebbe a toccare tutte le sostanze chimiche di Rosita, magari creando un vuoto spazio-temporale, poi alla fine Rosita dovrebbe sistemare tutto. Tamara dice che Rosita ha dato un pugno era una donna incinta, quindi comunque alla fine non è carino. This is the last question.
Melanie, did you prefer kissing Wolverine or?
No. I'm gonna go with Doc.
That's rude.
Fucking strano.
If you will ever come back, can your character please stop stealing other girlfriends and
find her own?
Yeah.
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 I love that. That'd be great. And there are other women in the world who would want to be with Rosita. Like another. Who else on the show could I date?
Shady.
Shady. Oh my God. Best nation film ever.
Chiede se Rosita dovesse tornare in vita, può per favore smetterla di rubare le ragazze delle altre, perché non è carino. Sì, comunque Tamara è d'accordo. This was our last question, guys, and we have Melanie's autograph now. And first we have the air pass and then the J pass. Quindi adesso abbiamo gli autografi di Melanie e ora, proprio subito, prima ieri e poi i passi giornalieri.